All right, what is up, everybody? We are here today with the second poll winner on the Discord. It is this lady right here, Fondant Solace Mediell. Oddly enough, she was in the first poll, and it was funny that she decided to jump into the second poll. She just really, really wanted to be played, so I guess she's getting played today. So we'll be playing her exclusively. Looks like you got affiliate approved. Grats. Yes, I just got it approved today. All right, so here we have the poll winner, Fondant Solace Mediell. She's an interesting card. Counterblast 2, act skill. You can reveal the top card of your deck, and you get a different effect depending on which type of card you reveal. If you reveal a normal unit, you get to add that card to your hand, and you get to call a card from your drop zone, and it gets a crit plus 1, so pretty nice. Very nice late game pressure. Especially with the grade 2 that I have in here. There's also, if you reveal a trigger unit, you get to countercharge one of those counterblasts. So, okay, you get a little bit of a refund. And then you just simply choose a card from your drop zone and you call it. But the problem is, of course, the opponent knows it's a trigger, so they may guard differently, knowing that there's a trigger on top. But it kind of lets you, it lets you know that you have a trigger, so maybe you can play more aggressively that turn to make up for, you know, your opponent probably going, oh, they have a crit, I'm going to change my game plan based on that. This is the star of the deck as far as grade 2s are concerned. When she attacks a van, she gets 5k, which is nice. She goes up to 15, can swing at a van on her own. And when she's placed on R from the drop zone by the ability of your grade 3 Vanguard with Mediell in the card name, she gets this effect by until the end of the turn. And that is, at the end of the battle, the Vanguard attacked. You can Soul Blast 1 and stand her. So as you can see, that's your way of dealing 4 attacks in this game, in this deck. And also, if you get a normal unit with your top check, then she gets a crit. Elise gets a crit, so she swings crit by herself, and then she swings crit again, which is pretty cool. Maybe can help you catch up in damage or try to finish them off at 4. There's a lot of cool uses with that. I also really, really like this card. I've seen decks run anywhere from 2 to 4, and I think this is a 4 of. I was doing a little bit of testing with this offline first. So Ninon here, when it's placed, if I have Mediell as the Vanguard, that means I can also do it, like, if I'm grade 2 as well, which is cool. I can look at the top card, and I can either keep that on top of the deck, or I can put it in my soul. This is a great way to get your soul back, because you're going to need your soul for this other grade 1 that's in the deck that you'll see later. If you put in the soul, then you get to check the next top card. So if it's a card I don't want to get to my hand, then I just throw it in the soul and see if I can get a different card. Very nice on turn 2, because on turn 2, they get to see what your top card is, and I'd rather change that. Here's the grade 2. When you ride on, when it's rode upon by grade 3 Mediell, you look at the top 3 cards of the deck. I can choose one card to put on top, and I can discard the rest. There's a lot of cards I want in my drop zone. It also deck thins. I could put a trigger on top for early pressure. Yeah, pretty good. I'm trying this card out, just for having a Mediell Vanguard. She gets 5k shield, so she's a 10k intercept or 10k block from the hand, so it's okay. I haven't really played much with this card, so we'll see if it works out today. Yeah, we got our 3 PGs. I run Yuika in my builds. I only run her as 2 because I can call her out of the drop zone, and she's not, like, super important. I just like her to loop with Ninon, because I can call Ninon, Soul Charge, check my top card, set it up. Yuika bounces her to my hand, I can do it again next turn. I just kind of like that little loop. Okay, so Bermuda Tsukuyomi. A little bit, although you don't have a stack. It's more so just seeing what the top card is. Here's the big grade 1 in the deck. I have 4 of it for a reason. So you can Soul Blast 2. You can make your grade 3 or greater Vanguard with Mediell in the card name counterblast 1 less for the cost. So it's just 1 counterblast to use her skill, which is pretty cool. That's why you want to build Soul up, because you want to use this ultimately to decrease the cost. You have a top deck stack, yeah, top deck stack instead of the bottom one. And on top of that, not once per turn, she gets 5k every time you play a card from your drop zone, which is pretty nice. You get big numbers. This card helps do that. If you play any rear guard by the ability of the Vanguard, which you're going to do every turn, you can counterblast 1 and she just comes right out to the field. So she's a nice little second call. And that's really nice because this will then get 10k power instead of just 5. And yeah, obviously if they retire your board, this card helps you get your stuff back, which is cool too. Your grade 1 is pretty nice. You get to... what was it again? You choose when wrote upon by the grade 2 Mediell, you choose up to one grade 2 or less card from the drop and you just call it to the field. So it makes discarding cards for your ride deck easier because you could just discard stuff you can call out later. She's your version of the dumb Kagero grade 1, yeah. So the ride line's pretty nice in this deck. This is another card that can help you get soul. If you have Mediell Vanguard, put it in the soul, you look at the top card of the deck and you can put it on the top or the bottom. So if you're looking for a trigger or something, or if you're looking to try to get a certain card in your hand, this card's great. Gives you 5K, and it also gives you 5K to something as a little bonus. Gives you soul, so you can soul blast cards and decrease your cost. So managing your cost is huge. Obviously we have this stupid OT that nobody likes. Then we have, I'm doing 4 heals, 8 crits, 1 OT, and the 3 fronts. I was running draws for a little while, but I think fronts are better in this deck, because you swing 4 attacks, and you want to power up that one card that gets a crit, you know. I think fronts better. Also a little bit of extra shield, because the deck doesn't have too much in its hand usually. Nobody likes it until they hit it. Yeah, exactly. You only like the OT when you hit it, and that's it. Obviously, we have our, you know, to be in theme, we have the Mediell starter. And then we have the two orders that everybody runs. We have one cup, and we have one, what do they call these things? Sanctitude. Sanctitude to deal with triple drive Vanguards. So yeah, that's what we're working with. I've got the briefing on the deck. I don't see me changing this deck during stream, and I also try to avoid... During streams like this, I also try to avoid changing the deck too much. Because we're trying to really just try to get data. Alright, we got somebody. Here we go. Somebody in Master Rank. They're 190. Eek. Okay, we have an okay start. We do have our loop in our hand, which is cool. I get to go first. Let's see what's going on here. It's not super high. Top 50 are 400 plus. Oh, okay. So it's not as high as I thought it was. Okay. We're gonna discard that. Because we can just call it... Actually, no. This is the thing I'm trying to do. So we're gonna try to... We're gonna discard that one. Because we're gonna call that one and attack with it. Because if they run it over, we could just call it back out. We don't really care. So we're gonna call it. And give them some pressure. Alright, what are we up against first? Oh boy. Lukier's first. Oh boy. Yep, he's no passing, but that's fine. That's why I called another card. Okay, we do want that card. That's a very good card. Also, Lukier doesn't retire our board, so we can call cards without the fear of her just, you know, using an effect and killing a card. So there's that too. Bad card, it doesn't matter. Wow. Okay. That's fine, I guess. Hit the OT if you want. Okay, gonna discard that. Okay, we're gonna see the... We're gonna call a card. Congrats on the sub button, thank you. We're gonna get this out of the drop zone. Play it here. I'm gonna play it here, because I'm not sure if it's gonna get rested. Okay, it isn't. It doesn't get rested. So we're gonna get a Persona in our hand. Rather not, honestly. So what I'm gonna do is... Let's see. I'm gonna move this back. We're gonna call this down. And use this skill. We're gonna put that in the soul. And see what the next card is. A heal. Okay, so not bad, that's pretty good. And it's gonna make it just a little bigger and we can push damage. And we're getting a heal here, so let's just push the Yeah, we're gonna heal the damage off, and then we're also gonna have a little more power. Okay, get a 15k shield to our hands, we're gonna deal damage here. Damage is a Lukier, so we can swing the 18k without any problems. Whoops, this one. Swing the 18k now. So as you can see, Mediell has a pretty nice early game. You can kind of call cards to the field and not care too much if they die, because you can call stuff out with her effect. And if you get normal units on the top of the deck, then you get to add that card to your hand, so you kind of get to rebuild your field, which is cool too. It's a little annoying. Alright. Yeah, the Yuika loop's not gonna really happen, so we're gonna ditch her. Alright, so we're gonna check the top three. Let's see here. Okay. So we're gonna put those. Oh, I put that on top. Oh well. Okay. That means we pitched the crit right now. We do get to add it to our hand, though. Our soul is 4, so we're going to decrease the cost a little bit. Soul Blast 2. Gets the 5k. And then we're going to use the skill. Counterblast a card that we would want in the drop zone. We add that to our hands, and we get to call a card from drop, which is going to be obviously Elise. She's going to get her crit. And we get a bunch of effects going off now. That's going to get 5k. That'll get her skill active. I think I'm going to hold off on the counterblast for now. You know what? No, we'll do it. We'll push hard early. Normally I hold stuff back, but I think this time I'm going to try to go in. Hey, what's up, Nintendo Pro? That gets another 5k. We're playing the poll winner. Mediell won by quite the margin. It was like 7 votes, and the others were 2 and 3. So yeah, people really wanted to see Mediell, apparently. So I'm trying not to disappoint. That's going to swing 5k with a crit. Alright, forces a 5k out of the hands right away. That is fine. Then we're going to swing the 24, or the 26. We don't know what's on top yet, but it's fine, I guess. Yeah, another one of those is kind of eh. Okay, PG's good. I'll take the PG. Good, no damage trigger. Okay. We're going to restand that rear guard. Last one, we stand. We have a 28 with a crit. That's gonna go in right now. Let's see if they take it. Well, 33, right. Always forget it gets an extra 5. Will they take it or will they guard this? Because they don't want damage that high. They're guarding it. Alright, so then I know what to do. To really mess her up. Unless they intercept with it. Okay, they go. Ooh, alright. Okay. I know what to do then. We're gonna do something really cheeky. I'm going to have this kill the rear guard. And now they only have one counterblast to. They can't use Lukier's skill and the order in the same turn. I have not seen Mediell at all. Well, you will be seeing her this time. Let's see here. Our soul is only 1, so we're gonna just use normal Mediell's skill. Methinks. I'm gonna call over with this, actually, so I'll just call it out of the drop zone. Because we still want to pressure that crit, potentially. But yeah, next time. You always want to try to intercept those off. And I guess that's a reason to use the 10k shields. Alright, so that's gonna go to the hand. And we're gonna call that from the drop zone. More crit pressure. The card behind is also going to get a 5k boost. Okay, because yeah, we want to shove crits in our opponent's face. Okay. So then, we go in with this. 15k with a crit. That's super guardable to them, so they're probably going to guard it. Yeah, intercept the Rising Dragon. Okay, so they might have another one in hand. So that's gonna go in. 21k. This is this. They're probably taking this. Yeah. Front trigger is nice. Okay, and nothing. Okay, it's gonna push them to 4. Lukier. Okay. We're gonna have you stand again. We're gonna use the last of our soul, which is a little worrying. We're not drawing any of our soul charge cards. So that's gonna swing for fatal. So they're gonna have to PG this or drop a lot of cards. They have two orders in their hand, I know that for a fact. Alright, so they're just dropping the PG. Trying to think. Do we give them the fifth damage? Because then they're gonna use their order again. Ooh, it's a tough call. I think I will pass. Because that's gonna prevent them from doing the order. Alright, we're gonna call this over. See the top card. That goes to the soul. We have to see another card. Still no trigger. Trying to fish for triggers at this point, because yeah. Alright, I do not have Soul Blast. I can't Soul Blast 2. Because yeah, we haven't been getting our rerides. Alright, all we can do is swing Van. This isn't the best turn. I really wanted to pressure that crit again, but we just can't right now. We need another soul. No, we need 3 soul total to do it with our current situation. We need to hit a trigger or something here. No. We're gonna lose next turn. Unless I swing at rears, then they can't do Lukier or the, they can't do Lukier or the order if we swing at the rears. Yeah, this is not the best showing. You really need your rerides in this deck. Like, that's why I thought about keeping that on top, but I think I'm gonna keep it on top from here on out, just so we can keep reriding. Because this deck kind of falls apart if it can't reride. Because that's how you get soul, it's how you get the numbers, etc., etc. Drew the crit, which is terrible! Alright, I need to get another soul. Cup is on top. That's gotta go to the bottom. I do literally nothing if I check that. Alright, 5k is going to the... I'm just gonna give it to Van. Alright, we're gonna use this. Oh no, we can't. Well, yeah, alright, we're not gonna get to call the card we want to call out, but we want to call something. So let's Soul Blast. Because the card we want to call is not gonna have soul. Alright, top card is that. So it goes to our hands. Yeah, unfortunately we have no other way to get soul. Right? Nope. No other way to get soul. This sucks. 18, yeah, it doesn't matter. May as well just get the card, it gets 10k. Alright, it gets a crit. That's gonna get 5k to make it a little stronger. Yeah, we need like OT or something crazy right now. We've been thinning our deck a lot, but we can only live one more turn. Not even, actually, they get 2 turns if they play correctly. So, not great. We kind of need to check, like, crit or something here. Heal is nice. That may keep us in the game. That one. Power to the crit. I don't know if that's enough for a comeback, but we'll have to see. Swing 33 with a crit. I don't think that's big enough. Thank God we got too easily. Then we swing at rear and pass. That's all we can do. At this point, we're trying to win by deck out, or to get lucky with crits. That's all we can do. That stops Lukier's skill, that stops the order, so, I mean, at least that, I guess. We have some options. Don't leave survivors. Agreed. Okay, we're gonna call this down. I'll move this up, in case we get a trigger. We're gonna keep all this in our hand just in case, because we're just gonna deck them out at this point. I'll swing Van once. No, wait, I don't think I should. Yeah, I don't think I should. Alright, kill that one. Hilarious that he's trying to stall when he's going to deck out next turn. Yeah, he is. I tried to play this match as carefully as possible. That's a nice crit. Ooh, okay. Give that all there. Kill or be killed, yeah. I'm actually gonna have that swing at Vanguard, and either he takes it and loses anyway, or he guards it. Because he has literally two deck cards left in his deck. Yep. And he can't swing Vanguard anyway next turn. Okay, he's just gonna do the order PG. Okay, even if you hit him for one, he loses next turn. That's true. That's true, I should have given it there, but it's fine. I'm always at my worst when games get drawn out like this. My brain just starts fuming. Here we go, I guess. No guard. No reason to. Havachi. Yep, game. Alright, we won the first one by deck out. Not how I expected it, but here we are. We got our first win with Mediell, and that was with deck out, I guess. I would need to get the game to play with you next, but I need to learn how to play again first, lol. Yeah, no, honestly, it's not too bad, Neri. It's about the same as when we played back in the OG days. The only difference is you have a ride deck and you don't get grade locked because of it. Maybe next time I'm over your place or something, I can like show you on my Switch how it works, if you want. Alright, we're just gonna mull two. Pitch that one. I think going first we pitch that grade one because we won't call it to the field to attack. That seems to be the strat early game with Mediell. This time we're gonna pitch this. Ride. Check the top card, it's gonna be revealed to you anyway. We're gonna call this. It's a front, so it rests. That's unfortunate. Alright. I do get the skill though. Do I wanna do it though? I don't think so. Alright, we'll just do this. Oh, yeah, I realized that still swings anyway. Okay, right, because they're on grade 1 regardless. Alright, we're going to hit our front here. So, pretty nice top deck, even if they hit a trigger. As an idea, I've been here from the start and have 500 so far. Okay, yeah, that's exactly what I wanted to see. I wanted to see how quickly people were getting points. So I could get, like, an actual good... And I haven't been grabbing the bonus chest, right? Because you're probably still working. You're just having me here as background noise. I'm thinking, like, 300, maybe? Ooh, okay. No. I think I'm gonna still do this. Okay, move this up. Because we're not gonna be too live this turn anyway. Okay. Swing 13. Swing that 13. They're doing a YOLO one pass. Ooh. I'm going to give the crit here and the power here. Actually, nah. Scratch that. Just give it all to Van. Push him to four right there. Because if they hit one damage trigger and I don't hit another trigger, then that doesn't hit Van. So let's just do that. Okay, 10 shield. That breaks the guard, they take 2 damage. Okay. That breaks. And then that'll just go in at Vanguard. Threatens 5 damage. But yeah, I'm up for hearing recommendations as well if you guys have any cool ideas to spend channel points. Okay, we pushed on the 5 already. Here we go. We take that. We don't know what our top card is. I can find out what it is, but it's going to sacrifice our field presence. So I'm just going to go for it. Counterblast 2. See what the top card is. We non-trigger, so it goes to our hand. And we call a card from our drop zone. And that's going to be the card that I just guarded with. Boom. It's going to get a crit as well for good measure. We're going to counterblast 1 and call that from the drop zone. That'll just go there. Make that crit stronger, and I think we'll just go in with this. Yeah. Okay, got some good pressure at 5. To guard the trigger. Intercept. Still one pass. One pass, okay. And we get it. We got it. Oh man. Mediell went in this game. That was nuts. Okay. This is looking like our second win already. Mediell's performing well. We got a heal here, though. But will they hit another? Nope. Alright. We got ourselves a second win with Mediell. Mediell's proving pretty good so far. Alright, here we go. Roku the Dawn, apparently. Six the Dawn. Oh, we drew the OT. Ugh, I hate that. Alright, scored the 2. I'll just stick with 2. I don't know how you keep finding Lupierre's. I never see her. Yeah, I don't know, dude. I don't know. I have no idea how I keep finding them now. I think she's a really solid deck. Okay, damage to Persona Ride. That's pretty nice. And a PG. Okay. Alright. Okay. We got them the 3 already. Alright. Yep, we got... Whoa! Another... Okay. They're only going to Persona once this game, unless they draw a cup. Alright, top we're going to call a card from drop. Boom. And... Boom. That's the top card. Okay, so they know it's not a trigger. But we can fix that, because we can call this down. And that could put it in the soul. That's on top now. Well, we get that to our hand. That's a good card to get to our hand. Alright, get that down, and we're going in. Well, before, we have to do that first. There we go. Okay, so we have a non-trigger on top. Because of that, we're going to swing Van first. We'll intimidate them. Maybe they'll two-pass us. Because they don't know what the top card is now. Sweet! That's exactly what I wanted to see. Because we're not getting a trigger. Okay. Very good. We're going to swing this next. That's 18k. At the Vanguard. We'll push them to 4 damage. If they don't hit a damage trigger, then we'll just go at Van again. Push him to 5. And with a low card in low cards in hand. Okay, alright, no damage trigger. Yuika goes off, Soul Blast 1. She'll go back to our hand and we can loop her. We can use her again next turn. And that'll go 18k Van. So they're either going to guard a card out of their hand to block this, or they're going to go to 5. So, yeah. Cool. He PGs it. Very cool. They're going to have one card in their hand on their Lugia turn, because they have to discard one to ride Lugia. Alright. Nice. Because now they're going to put one in from their hand into the soul. So they're keeping Lillian in their hands for guarding, because it gets a 5k shield on guard. He's going to call 3 cards out to make up for, you know, his field presence. If we were fighting anybody else, they'd be crying right now. They'd be like, crap, I can't even build a field. Oh, okay. Alright, Mediell's coming down now. Alright. This is really risky, but I need this and I need this. Well, actually, I guess I don't need that grade 1. Nah, I don't need that grade 1. I can live without the grade 1. Oh, was that... Yeah, there's a PG in his hand. Alright, check the top few. Ooh, okay. We're gonna put the heal on top. Or... force them to drop the PG first. Yeah, I gotta force the PG. Ooh, this is hard. We could either put the crit on top and make 2 attacks fatal, which I think is honestly our best bet, instead of getting a heal. I think we're gonna do that. We'll just... Wait, no, no, we're gonna call a card now. So we're gonna use this effect. Counterblast 2. This is gonna reveal the top card to them. So now they know there's a crit. That doesn't matter too much with their hand so small. So this is going to unflip. We're going to call a card. I really wanted to call a card in the front, but I don't think it's going to happen. We're going to have to just call this one. Actually, I'm going to call this behind Vanguard. And then call that grade 2. No, because we need a better number than that. Alright, call the grade 2. That's going to get 5k. That'll make it harder for him to guard the crit. And then, yeah, this is just going to take us take a look at the top card, and we're going to make sure we keep it on top, because that crit is our, hopefully, our game ender. Alright, here we go. We're just going to go in like this. 20k going at Van. There's a crit on top of the deck. He's probably going to PG the Vanguard. I'm hoping he does, because he knows there's a trigger on top, so he can't risk one pass, and he might be scared to do 2 pass. Yeah, fortunately, we couldn't get him to drop the crit, or drop the PG. So he's gonna PG it anyway. I'm trying to think. He's gonna PG my attack anyway. Do we go for the 2 pass? No, it's not even a 2 pass. Alright, so yeah, we don't have a choice. We're just gonna give it here. No, it's not a 2 pass. I'm wrong, because I'll only go up to 40k. Alright, a front's nice. Kind of. Not really. Damn. Yeah, unfortunately, he had 2 triggers. Alright, that's gonna get met with a PG. And so I was tempted to put the heal on top instead, so that we have more survivability. But it is what it is. No. Yeah, just go in. He's got counter blasts anyway. Let's just get him to 5. If we survive next turn, then we'll have an easier time just ending it. Okay. Killed a PG. There's lag going on here. Oh, are they... I think they're thinking about forfeiting. Yeah, they scooped. Okay. We got him anyway, because I guess they read that we had a PG, or maybe we drove checked it or something. But, okay. Mediell. Is this why you guys wanted to see Mediell so bad? Because she's secretly a beast? Mind you, I'm not even, like, having optimal turns. Like, this is just kind of very, like, average gameplay with her, and she's just going in. I guess partially we're getting lucky, though. Our opponent's not hitting triggers early and messing us up this time. But yeah, look at that. 3 wins. 0 losses. I had no idea what she did. Yeah. Well, you're getting a taste of what she can do now. She's pretty reliable, honestly. She's kind of a reliable card. Okay, we get a rematch against Roku da Dawn. Roku that Dawn, so I guess we'll see. Seems like a weaker version of the Magus deck. A little bit. But then again, if we're talking V, and those decks' power levels were through the roof. Alright, so we're fighting, again, Lucia. Alright, we'll discard this and call it out of the drop zone. Even though we don't know what the top card is, that's still better than dropping the rest of those cards. I don't want to drop the rest of them. I want to keep the rest. Okay, it's a non-trigger on top, so I get to keep this as stand. I can use the effect. I will, because I already have 2 PGs. I don't want to have a third one already. That way they don't know what the top card is. We have a heal on top. Very cool. Very cool. Skill, we're going to check top 3, mill 2, and put the other on top. I think we're going to do that. Just keep our damage at 0. Alright. Plus 1 soul, draw a card, to the front, not the best. The card we're going to call out is definitely going to be this one. We need this on the field now. Instead of going for that crit. Yet. Alright. We're just going to counterblast 2. We got to get that grade 1 on the field now. Alright, that's going to go to our hand, so we don't have to call it out. Instead, we can just go for the Elise. Right there is fine, yeah. Having a hard time, eh? Not this time, Yubel. Quite the opposite. Kill something. We probably will. That'll swing 2 with 20k with crit right out of the gate. 25 with crit right out of the gate. That's going to force a trigger out of their hand. I don't think they want to just take an easy... Yeah, they're not going to want to take an easy 2 damage like that. Okay. 50k shield down. That goes in. We don't know what our top card is yet. We're going to find out now. It's the over trigger! Holy! The crit is going to get all the power. This rank? Okay, we got another one of those. Damn, we get an OT even. What is going on today? Alright, there's a front trigger, I guess. It's gonna get damage. We're gonna restand this. I'm gonna soul blast the PG in some weird niche situation. We wanna bounce it, I guess. Restand that. Yeah, that's a billion power anyway, so we're going to swing this first. If he's going to PG that, he's going to PG that. So we're going to swing this first. Which I think he does have a PG in his hand, so that's just going to force it out. Yeah, they're going to take this, go to four, that's fine. Okay. And then we're just going to swing this. And they're just going to use their PG. Right, forgot Vanguard has the worst rank ladder. Yeah, it's not amazing. Another Persona Ride, draw. We drew a crit, which isn't the best. We have a lot of soul. Soul Blasts. Knock the cost down by one. Get 5k. We don't know what the top card is. I don't want to throw that in soul just to find out, though. Yeah, we're just going to go for it. Counterblast 1. I don't think it's going to be a trigger. It is. Okay. We unflip. We call a card. We're going to call that Restander. That's going to get 5k. That's going to get its skill. We don't have to call the drop zone card, because we're already swinging 20k, 28k, which is pretty much going to be a PG anyway, probably. So I'm not going to call it. Let's save our counter blasts. If they were at 4, I would do it, but since they're at 3, I'm not. So that's going to be a 35k on its own. There's a crit on our top deck. So something's going to get 10k more power in a crit. So they could take this. Oh, they're guarding it. All right. Yeah, it's going to get 5 shield. Okay, we're a little nervous for next turn. Attack that van, we got a crit coming. Now, were they paying attention? I'm pretty sure they know there's a crit coming. Because I revealed it. Yeah. Okay, they're guarding with their OT. So here's a crit. That is 47, and that is 53. I guess we'll give it there. I think they have a PG in their hand, though, unfortunately. We have 1 PG, 2 15 shields, a 10 shield. We can intercept. This might still be okay. We can take 1 damage. That heal last turn really screwed us up, though. And we're definitely going to swing, because they can call out that grade 3 that can unflip anyway. So they're going to do their full combo next turn. They're taking this. Yeah, they have a PG in their hand. I know they do. We're basically just trying to get it out of their hand at this point. They took it? I thought they had a PG. Oh, they used it last turn. Oh, no way. Are we going to get a fourth win? Oh, unreal. Unreal. Mediell. What is going on? I'm, like, almost afraid. Holy. Okay, 4 wins. We're about 2 hours in, and we have 4 wins. I'm really surprised. Oh, are we fighting this guy again? Oh, damn. Mediell officially better than Kyrie and Busty Curse Waifu, apparently. Like, damn. This are gonna be a little skewed because we keep getting this guy. But he's not a bad player. Like, he seems to be playing fine. So I don't know. I'd like to get different matchups, though. We're gonna call this out later. We'll draw for starter. We're drawing our heal, which isn't the best, but what can you do? Alright, going in with these. This has worked out for us before. And Persona? Mediell! What are you doing? I don't know what to say right now. This is crazy. Two. We're going to discard our two. Still better odds than other decks, and with Lugia Air Force's Solitaire, that puts you at the advantage. Yeah. My effects. No, that goes here. Actually, let's put it here. Let's put it there. Cool, that's the top card. It doesn't have to rest. Neat. We can mull it, but we kind of need that card. And we have big numbers, so let's just swing. Swing the 10. We'll hit no trigger, but if he hits a damage trigger, both of these other attacks can do something, so we're still sitting pretty good if they hit a trigger. And we got a pretty valuable card for next turn. Alright, they did hit the trigger. Which is okay. 20k still hits. The 18k can swing at the rear. Okay. And then that'll go in for 20. Yeah. Hex Orb is technically better, but that on top, those go to the drop zone. We move this back. Call this here. We do want to still call the card from drop zone, even if we'll reveal the crit, but, you know, revealing the crit really doesn't put us at a, it still makes it awkward for them. Unflip that one, call a card from drop zone, we need another attacker, and that's the best one. Just make it bigger, too. Let's just really capitalize on that OT. Alright, that's 20k, 25k going in. We have a 38, 13 Vanguard. He was probably, yeah, just gonna take that because it's an easy guard. Just guard a trigger. Mediell will go in. 13k. They're going to two pass it. Crit. That one is 37, that one is 38. So we'll just do what we did last time. We'll stand that and swing the crit afterwards. Okay, we need that for next turn. Probably. Maybe. Soul Blast. Okay, that's gonna go in for 37. He will probably take this and guard the other attack. Oh, 42. Okay, yeah, he's taking this and guarding the other attack, most likely. Alright. Here comes PG. That's fine, we need to get it out of his hand. Yep, there it is. At least has to pitch a card to do so. Okay. The beefy, yeah, we're gonna take this, because if they hit crit, we have to take it anyway. Alright. OT to win the game. That's fine. We'll take a loss. We have four wins. I'm not too mad about that. that kind of evens it out a little bit. Because we got lucky in a lot of games. I'll gladly fight when I get off work. I don't need to be merciful, though, it seems today, so it will be Ava. Yeah, nah, go in with Ava. Cool, we got somebody else. So, Mediell's still looking pretty good so far. Yeah, pitch that. Draw. Call this out. And this has worked out for us so far, so we're just gonna keep doing it. Swing that AK. No trigger this time. Okay. Is this that deck that sets you to one power that I've... Yes. That you've never fought. Yeah, what is it with that, Tai Chi? You fight completely different things than I do. Look at this. That has no business being in her hand. Okay. The 10 shield. He goes hee hee ha ha, we can intercept it again. Oh, that's on the top. And then we'll accomplish nothing. Alright, they're just gonna take it. That's curious. Did they not pay attention? Because they do see the card. They have to in order to confirm that I have to rest the card, so... I don't know. That's weird. Okay. They're at 3. Lost PG and a Swirler, which is cool. Is now swinging 28, so they have to guard a crit. They have to guard a trigger and a 5k to block this, or a front or something. Okay, they'll just take it and go to 4. Doesn't mean they have the cards to guard this early. Yeah, they, sometimes people just take damage early and anticipate heals. They should have played during Limit Break era, right? Everybody just purposely went to 4. So that they can do their Limit Break effects. Which would then cause people to purposely not give Limit Break. So they'd just be like, no, I'm gonna keep you a 3 forever. And I hate it when a game gets to that point where it forces people to purposely play like that to prevent the game state from moving forward. I think that's where that mindset came from, really, yeah. Damage early. Yeah, it might have came from Limit Break. Any of the people that were around at that point, which I imagine is a fair share of the Vanguard community, has been around since the beginning. I like that the Swirlers are activating now while I only have one damage. That's how we'll do it. Thanks to our 10k intercepts, we can do it. Very cool. And that also opens up a spot for us to call a card, so that works out. Yeah, we're gonna have to, I think. Actually, no. We're pitching this. Because we're gonna call a card from drop zone. We need that for the extra soul later. Alright, check the top view. Place that crit on top. We have 3 soul, which is not quite enough to comfortably use the effect, so we're just going to go right ahead and use the Mediell here. We will reveal the crit, but that's fine. That's just gonna make him sweat. Because he's at 4 damage. We're gonna call our re-stander friend here. Alright, that's gonna get 5k. And she's gonna get her skill. Okay, so. I'm not swinging at Vanguard. I'm having to swing at Rearguard first. We're gonna take out the Swirler before it gets any bigger. And this restands anyway. So I can swing at a rear first. Get the effect. Yep, just as long as the Vanguard attacked, it's gonna restand. Okay. Fortunately, they did that. I'm gonna make this bigger. Yeah, I should have played that 7k behind the van. That was not a good idea. Oh my god, double crit. Well, this works out. Give it to each lane. Each lane's fatal. I should have put the 7k behind the man. Because that would have made it that they had to guard more than just that. But he's got to guard both of these. I guess he's seeing if he can. You know what? I was iffy about putting this in, but she's putting work in. She's doing pretty well. Allows you to guard early. Okay, they're dropping a PG here, which makes me think they definitely have they're definitely able to guard the other attack. Which I think is fine, because they have to push cards out of their hands to stop these attacks. Oh, I just realized I swung with the bigger comm first. It didn't matter. It doesn't matter, because, yeah. It ended up being the same thing. Got a PG to our hand. We have two soul. Right, that doesn't get its effect. But I guess we can live with that for now. I don't want to minus it and then call over a trigger. That's just not a good idea. We're going to use the skill. We can afford to counterblast too. Reveal the top card. Non-trigger goes to our hands. Oh, that means we call a card with a crit. I think this is the game I pitched another one. Yeah, there it is. We're going to call over then. We'll just call over this. There we go. Now her effects are active. And she's got a crit. And I can swing it twice, which is big. That's plus 5. That's going to get her effect. I think we're going to go for a big push here. So I'm going to counterblast one and call that. Maybe doesn't have a PG, I'm not too sure. And that's also going to get another 5k, so that's, yeah, that's the time to do it. 5k with a crit to the Vanguard, and it has a crit, they're not taking it, they gotta guard it. There it is, guarding the trigger, crit, yep. Alright, that's gone. Then the Vanguard goes in, big 31. Big 31k. We don't know our top card. He's risking it. We got the over trigger. Oh boy. Giving it all to the one with the crit. And then a heal on top of it all. Oh my god, Mediell. Just... wow. What is happening right now? Right, they got a crit on defense, which might not really matter, actually. He just gave it to his back row. I think he just thinks he's screwed, so he just said whatever and put it in his back. Alright, we're swinging the big bajillion attack. We're ending this now. Come on. Let's end it. Let's go for win 5. Let's do it. Did they run out of time or something? He's acting really strange. Maybe he's... Alright, we win. Win 5. Holy. Seems like a rage move to me. Yeah, I think he just knew he was done. He thins the deck out, sort of, and then makes it likely to hit triggers. And then she just gets to call stuff out of the drop zone. That's what she has over Hex Orb, is that she has more consistency because she can call stuff out of drop zones. So that's kind of like what separates the two. Like, with Hex Orb, you're going to get guaranteed triggers on top of your deck. And with Mediell, you maybe will hit more likely to hit triggers, but you'll also get to call cards out of your drop zone, which is pretty big. And you got that cool restanding card that gets a crit, so, you know. It's pretty much just preference, which one you like more. I wouldn't say one's better than the other. But Mediell is just going in. I don't know if it's just meshing with my playstyle really well. I don't know if I'm just getting insanely lucky. It's very hard to say. Very hard to say. But then again, if you took White Wings and you put it in this spot, I wouldn't be having this record. It wouldn't be 5-1. So the deck matters at least a little bit. Call it later. Okay, Mage's Entry. Now, this is the one time I wouldn't rush, because Blaster Dark can kill a rear, kill one of my rears, and then get Twin Drive. So this is the one matchup I would not call another Grade 1 to attack with. It's just giving him too much value. Like, even though I can just counterblast... Ugh. Okay, this is gonna be maybe the game we get sacked back. Okay. Yeah, we'll call this out of drop zone later. We'll swing one attack this time. We have to call a card out anyway, I forgot. Then just call the one that can come back. Trigger, it gets rested anyway. But we heal! So that's cool. Do call stuff from drop zone, but not that much. Nah, screw it. I think we'll call enough to get by. Yeah, we're gonna keep that on top. That's way too nice. Okay, so they can two pass this, but then we'll hit a heal. And heal the damage off regardless, and then hit them again, probably. And we also get that in the drop zone, which is big. Because we need that in the drop zone. Okay, that's fine. If I didn't see a trigger, I would have just swung ban, but... I saw a trigger, so that means this is threatening him. They'll either drop a card or go to two. Swing 27. And they can only kill one rear. Alright, force the heal out. Well, skill. Check top three. Oh boy. Yeah, we do not want... One thing to note about Mediell. Never ever let an order card... Nope! I just said never let an order card go to the top and I freaking did it. I got confused. Because now I don't get my effect. So we're just going to swing vanilla. Alright, you know what? I'll play it off like, yeah, you know, I want that PG in my hand. Whatever. But don't let an order card be the top card, because if you use Mediell's skill, you get literally nothing out of it. Persona Ride. Get you another PG. Alright, we have to just go for it. Counterblast these two. Okay, that's gonna go to our hand, and then we're gonna call a card out, and it's gonna get a crit. So we're gonna call our restander friend. It's gonna be 25k with crit on its own. That's gonna help us come back a little bit. We're also gonna get that out of our drop zone. Okay, your skill is going to be active, and, you know, I guess you can still do something with no field. This is still doable. Swing 20k with a crit. 25k with a crit, I always do that. Yeah, they'll force a trigger out of their hands, and then, yeah, we need to hit, like, double heal or something. Even one heal will... feel a little more comfortable. Because either way, we're going to PG Overlord next turn. Crit. I assume the problem this game was he rushed you when you started off with a bunch of PGs, yes. Alright, I'm gonna give it all to... No, you know what? We gotta catch up a little bit, so I'm gonna take the risk. Let's get him the 2 damage, because I think this is gonna get PG'd. Good morning! Good morning, Pisces. Okay, and then that's gonna restand. And swing. They hit two defensive, so we're not going to force a PG out. And we'll force cards, a card out. Okay, we lose this one. That's fine. Honestly, we're doing exceptionally well today. So that loss barely phases me. Alright, nobody spent any points, so I guess we're gonna continue rank fight with Mediell. 5 wins, 2 losses, looking pretty good. Ready here. Some guy in Master with a 1255 rating. We got an okay hand. We don't need 2 Yuikas. Oh, we're fighting this deck again, probably. Yes. Call a card out of drop zone. We'll call Yuika. The heal's on top. That's a trigger we didn't want to see right now. Alright, I'm going to move this one back because I can't attack anyway. I'm going to call this one over here. Because if it dies, I don't care too much. And then just go in with this. That way they can't just... I mean, yeah, this is a blaster player. They're going to take the hit anyway, but I'd rather just push damage if they're going to retire one of my rears anyway. Ugh. Stupid draw trigger. I think the luck's starting to catch up to us now. Push him to 2. Good, waste of a crit. Alright, I'll pitch that. It's true we don't get our skill this turn. That's probably the other reason they did that. Alright, we're still gonna put the heal on top. Because we do not want the order. And... I might actually soul that heal. If I put it on top, it's a little suspicious, but it might scare him too. Yeah, I think I want to scare him. Yeah, I'm not going to commit the one yet. Our hand is just too small. I'm actually going to call that down and use the skill. Soul Blast 2 to make it 1. Counter Blast instead of 2. Get 5k. Use skill because we don't know what's on the top. Oh, right. It's only a Counter Blast. I forgot. It's a trigger anyway. Okay. That's going to scare him. And we're going to get the Restander. Fortunately, we don't have much else. 5k. Your skill is live. And on top of that, we're calling this little number to the field. Counterblast 1. We Persona Rode, right? Yeah, we did. So we're going to call this to the front, actually. There we go, nice little 18k attacker there, and this gets 5k more power. We got a bit of a push here, which is cool. 20k first, because it's going to restand. Taking it! Did they just throw? Because they know we had the crit on top. What? I don't know what's going on today, but that's win number 6. What happened? They saw the crit. With Mediell's skill, you see that you reveal the top card to your opponent. They see the card. Did they just not pay attention, or did they just have such a bad hand? They were like, screw it, I'm just gonna scoop here and die. But okay, we got win number 6. This is insane. I don't think we'll ever see a record like this again, because this is just, like, what is happening? This is probably the same person. You know, this is what you're gonna find on the stream, online usually. It's like because they smelt that crit on top of the deck, is that why? Alright. It doesn't do anything for us. That doesn't do anything for us either. Well, that's decreasing the odds of a trigger being on top of our deck for our 3-2 ride. Yeah, we still had a trigger. But there's a crit on top of the deck, so you know what that means. We're calling these two out. Yep. Because we gotta push that crit. If we lose that grade one, we'll just call it back out, so it's not a big deal. Mm-hmm. 28k with a crit. If you want to block it, you're not going to get your dark effect. Yeah, I didn't think so. So I pushed it in his face. Alright, one of those twos are down. And then healed. Oh, he doesn't get the heal. Nice! Because we're at two. Put one on top. Yeah, that heal's definitely going on the top of my deck. Alright. And gonna do this. Counterblast two. Heal. They know a heal's coming, which, whatever. And unflip that one. And call a card out. It's gonna be the Restander. Boom. And then we can also, yeah, activate the effect. So it restands. Use that. Counterblast one. Comes to the field. I'm just gonna put it there. Because if they hit a damage trigger or something, then I'll just not restand it. That's gonna go at the rear first. That goes in at Vanguard. We are probably giving the 28 versus. We're gonna heal. We're gonna heal off that one. And yeah, they're guarding this, so we'll just make it's 18 versus 20. Yeah, I don't really care to swing a Phantom Blaster Dragon. So we will restand that. Okay, 18, let's make this 30 with a crit. Sure. That works. So blast, restand. Oop. So let's just swing 18 and then 30 with crit. I think either way he's gonna guard that crit. Damage check. Alright, we risked the damage trigger and it worked out there. So now we're swinging full value, 30k out of 10. So that's gonna force them to do like two triggers or PG it. I'm doing five, okay. Alright, there goes the Sanctitude. And one of those. Let's see what our top card is. Alright, that goes to our hand. Which is cool for us because that means we're going to call this and it's going to have a crit. It's not a strong rear guard, but it's something. So we're definitely going to get a booster behind that. Even if it's just going to be a 7. Not much else we can do. They didn't have another one of those green ones in there, right? Okay. 15k with a crit, that is going to absolutely demand he guard it somehow. He's probably just going to intercept Blaster Dark. At least that's what I would do. What? Are you not paying attention? I don't even know if I should count that as a win. But I guess we will. Did they not realize that I got a normal unit? So, did you flip the record with from White Wings? Yeah, I did. This is insane. I didn't think Mediell was going to do this well today, but here we are. I guess people don't realize, I guess they don't know how this deck works, and they didn't pay attention that when I reveal a normal unit, the card I call out of drop zone gets a crit. Kyrie is going to be 0-10 calling it. Yeah, the card that's supposed to be like one of the best decks. I'm going to get like a crappy ass score with it. All right, let's go. I'm ready. There's a true test of the deck's strength now. Here we go. He's going first. I believe he's bringing out Ava. Here we go. So obviously this one, and we'll check. Yeah, we reveal the top card. It's a trigger, so it gets rested. Knowing that, we do our thing. It's taking it anyway. Okay, crits. Crit power.
Damage check. Damage check.
Got a crit on defense. Okay.
Critical plus. Power plus.
Alright, this goes in for 28. Guardian with Obscadeed. Yep. Blast those two. We're going to reveal the top card. It's going to be a normal unit, so it's going to go to our hand. And then a card's going to be called from the drop zone with a crit. Yeah, now's the time to do this. We're going to call this out. Once again. Let's see. That gets 5k. And that gets skill. Alright, we definitely need this Yuika. Okay. We can go in with this. That's gonna be 15k with a crit.
Got
Right, Mediell goes in. You getting better with Mediell? Apparently, this is like... This deck is a monster in my hands. I don't know what's happening today. Look at the win record, like... Insanity. Okay, you two passed it. Let's see here. Like, I might actually climb ladder with this deck. It's just going in. Okay, 18 with a crit. Yeah, I think we still swing with this first. Because if he hits one damage trigger, this doesn't hit Van anyway. So I think we have to do that. Oh, it's going to be 23 with a crit. It's the same number, but it's fine. We'll swing this first. Maybe we'll push him to 5. Join us in the land of 5 damage. Oh yeah, Nintendo Pro, stick around because I'm going to be streaming the... at the end of the stream, I'm actually going to spin the wheel to decide what our next 3 decks for the poll are going to be. So you guys will get to see it live.
No guard. Damage check.
I do have Persona. Okay, I drew an okay card. Two soul, so we do not want to use the skill of the grade 1. We want to use just the Vanguard by itself. We gotta get that little best friend grade 2 out. Reveal a non-trigger, perfect. Gonna go to our hand. That's going to be played right here. It's gonna get a crit. Yuika is gonna get 5k power. Phyllis is gonna get 5k power. And that's gonna get her skill active. And we're just gonna call this to have another front row attacker if need be. It's going to be 18k on its own, and we go in. That's going to force a crit, or a trigger, or that with the card. Really? Whoops. Oh. Didn't notice the 5k, yeah. Yeah, she gets 5k when she attacks the a grade 3 Vanguard. Perfect guard. PG. Okay. Soul blast. Swing. That's fatal yet again. Okay, PG's coming down. He's gonna discard a card from hand. Another PG, okay. Seems like there's a bunch of defensive cards in hand. Do I bounce it? Do I want to save my soul? I'll bounce it. I may not get to use my skill next turn anyway. Alright. That's gonna just kill Rugard. If that card's not an obscure, it won't come back. That gets 5 shields. Okay. Yeah, it's gonna go in and unflip anyway. Okay, so Ava can do her thing, yep. That's why Ava's a really solid deck. That's going in. I think an Opskadeed's coming out. By the looks of it. Yep.
クリティカル発動。クリティカルプラス。能力発動。完全防御。チェックザドライブトリガー。チェックザドライブトリガー。ゲット。クリティカルトリガー。
So you have 20k shield in your hand and two intercepts.
クリティカルプラス。パワープラス。ヴァンガードにアタックだ。スキル発動。パワープラス。能力発動。完全防御。
I luckily had all those PGs, so it's a good thing I bounced that card because that gave me a card to discard. Nothing to ride. Oh, no soul. I can't do my skill. Okay, I just have to go in. It's 5k. You might still have this depending what I check. It really depends what I check. Yeah, two pass. That's what I figured was happening. The front, ooh. I don't know if that's enough. I don't think that's enough because the Opskadeets can intercept for 10 shield. I'm gonna take this one and then just guard the other one attack. Too bad I'm not Willista. If I was Willista, you couldn't intercept. But I'm not. Alright, we have to bank on heal next turn. And I'm down to my last heal, so I think this is over regardless. Yeah, okay. Well, that was a very good game. That was actually an intense final game for this stream. I'll take that loss. Either I had insanely good luck today, or it's a sleeper deck. Tai Chi and I are basically just saying that any deck that can scry, that can set up triggers on the top of their deck, that can deck thin, or have inherent crit pressure in certain places, because Mediell, a big reason Mediell is so powerful is because Elise here, if you check a non-trigger on top of your deck, it not only goes to your hand, but this card can come out with a crit, and this card restands. So this is a huge, huge factor in a Mediell game. I would argue inherent crit on Rearguard is stronger than on Vanguard. People are afraid of Vanguard without inherent crit because it can always check one. But people depend on their taking Rearguards through to take damage, exactly. So when your opponent's at 3 damage, and you're already swinging a crit, even if it's 15k, they're sweating. They're like, crap, I have to guard this. And inherent crit on Rearguard is really scary. So this card right here, you could make an argument for this being one of the best cards in Lyrical. Like, this card is really good, and you could just call it out of the drop zone because it's paired with an excellent, like, the best boss it could be paired with because it can just call it out of drop zone. I used to be afraid of checking the top card and showing my opponent a trigger, but now I feel almost the opposite. I feel like, okay, there's a crit on top of my deck, what are you gonna do? And that, like, that scares them and forces them to guard when they otherwise wouldn't have, and I don't know. This deck creates some really weird mind games. If people aren't paying attention, this gets a crit. Like, I won a game because the guy wasn't paying attention. Because he had, like, a 6-card hand. He could have guarded me out that turn. I know he could have. I think, you know, it's really hard to explain why this deck did so well, aside from that. I'm guessing it's a mixture of what I've already explained, where, you know, it's very easy to manipulate. It's easy to hit your triggers. Maybe this just meshes with how I play the game. Because sometimes, I'll admit, I'm like, you know, I could rush turn one or whatever. But I don't want to be at some a lot of time because, you know, oh, they'll kill this rear guard and then I won't get to do anything. And, you know, that sort of stuff. But when I'm playing this deck, I can just do that and not care. Because you have this card, which is like, all right, they kill this. Counterblast one, it's going to come back. Don't care. You have this card. You want this in the drop zone. You don't care. I mean, even this. Like, you can call this. You can intercept with it. 10k shield. Then just call it back out again if you don't have Elise. And you have another 10k shield that can also attack. So I went in. I kept looking at this card when I was building this deck in the past. And I was like, I don't know. It doesn't seem that good. I mean, yeah, it gets 5 shield, you know. But with the way this deck works, it's actually pretty good. Like, usually, like, effects like this are kind of pack filler, but in this case, it's actually pretty good in this deck. And Mediell doesn't really have another dedicated grade 2 that it wants to run. Like, it wants to run this, obviously, and it wants to run this. But it doesn't have another one, so, like, you have room for this card. I think 2 is fine, actually. 2 seems to be a good number. You honestly could lose the Yuikas. I think as far as other options go, I mean, at least it's on an intercept. Yeah, it's on an intercept as well, so, like, they'll either attack it first to try to maybe lessen your shields, or they'll leave it there, and then you have a 10k intercept, which will let you empty a circle to call out a card from your drop zone on the next turn. So, you know, the deck really works well together. Like, it works really well. It may not be as crazy and zany as a lot of the top-tier decks, but this deck, you know, high roll or low roll, this deck might do well. And that's probably why I did well with it, because the Bouncer Lady seems not super necessary unless you want to use her to bounce a PG back. Yeah, I was testing it. I had a loop with this card, Yuika, where I would call this, and then I would fish the top card, throw it in the soul so I have soul, and then I would bounce her back to the hand with Yuika so that I can reuse her on the next turn and fish again. That was pretty much what my idea was. But maybe you need your soul more for this because this lowers your counterblast cost. So another option for this deck, I didn't play it on stream because I honestly wasn't crazy about this card, was this one, the promo that we got in the pack. So if you have a Vanguard with Hasseret or Mediell in its card name, and this unit was placed this turn, you get all of your trigger units on rear and in your deck are regarded as normal units instead. So what that would do is, normally when you check a trigger with Mediell, it stays on top of the deck and you just get to call a card from your drop zone. But if you check a normal unit, that card that you checked goes to your hand, and then you call a card from your drop zone and it gets an inherent crit. So what this can do is, you'll add the trigger you check to your hand instead, and then you still get to call a card from your drop zone and it gets a crit. So sometimes you want to do that, like maybe if it's a heal that you don't need, just add it to your hand and not care. But I don't know, if it's a crit, I kind of want that crit on the top of the deck, and that's kind of why I didn't put this in here. The other effect is kind of whatever. During your turn, if you have a grade 3 or greater Vanguard with Hasseret or Mediell in its card name, all of your other rear guards in the same column as this unit get 5k. So it just gives 5k to your front row attacker, which could be nice. But at the same time, when you call out a card out of drop zone, this gets 5k. And when I was running Yuika, when you call a card in front of her, she gets 5k. So they're both doing that anyway, and I felt like they were doing more, which is why I personally didn't opt to use this card. Don't you have that too that lets you see what's on top before you use Medi's effect? Yes, you do have this one. So theoretically, if you can make an argument where you could, you know what? I could test off screen. What I could do, and what you could do if you're curious about playing Mediell, is you could replace my 2 Yuikas for 2 of these. And if you want to try to fit a third in, I don't know what I would take out. Maybe one of this card. Or one of this card. You could try that and run 3 of this. But you only get that effect on the turn you play her, which is the part I'm not crazy about. And then after that, she's kind of just giving 5k to the front. So when Yuika and Phyllis do that, so it's kind of, it seems like a preference thing. You could do one or the other. Yeah, you could. There's an option, like, as far as changes. Like I said before, you could put two of this in and take the Yuikas out. You could live without Yuika. I liked it just because I could bounce a card to my hand so it doesn't get killed by a bind. Like, for instance, I knew Tai Chi was playing bind effects, so, and I didn't want this to get bound. You're kind of, you know, it's you could go either way. I don't think your results would change too much. It'll kind of depend on your matchup. But yeah, Mediell looking like one of the best decks in Lyrical. I think it's a major sleeper deck. I think it's a sleeper. Either that or it just really meshes with how I play the game. Because it takes away a lot of the things I'm afraid of. So it could just be that. But honestly, if you have a, you know, if you have a win-loss of 7-3, even if you're fighting the same guy in a row, because the guy we fought the same time in a row wasn't necessarily a bad player. So, you know, that seems to be the case. I think, I would say Mediell overall is a very solid deck. If you want to win on ladder, this is honestly a good bet. I don't think many people are playing this deck, and because of that, they don't really know how it works. So you can kind of catch them off guard. Setting triggers on top of your deck, or verifying that you have a trigger on top of your deck, is really good. Just really strong with the way how powerful triggers are in this game. Yeah. Really, really powerful.